This is our inaugural program that we've launched in counting jail number 5 with some really good, passionate, enthusiastic participants who have worked very hard to get their credentials here at Cisco Networking Academy. We're glad to be partnering with Cisco on this. We are the first one in the country to offer this type of program.
Okay.
As the founder George Duran always says, this is not a program, this is a movement. Programs end, but movements last forever. Let's give a warm round of applause to all the participants who are graduating here tonight. I'm very honored to have the opportunity to welcome all in attendance this afternoon. We, the board of M3, and all of our affiliates are in harmony to provide training programs such as the M3 Cisco Networking Essentials Training to encourage healthier and safer communities. This is not our only option for our people. Other innovative ideas and programs are coming down the pipe from the M3 in the future, so stay tuned and keep a lookout for those. We're just the beacon of light. We're offering our young men and women the opportunity to get training they need and take charge of their lives with the hopes to reduce recidivism and break down and reduce recidivisms in black and brown communities. This training is sponsored by our partners over at Cisco. Their vision and mission is to support and team with nonprofit organizations such as M3 and other organizations around the world to develop technology-based solutions focused on critical human needs, access to education, and economic empowerment. We focus this work on the underserved communities and look for solutions that harness the power of the internet and communications technologies. I would be remiss this evening if I did not thank a few people and give the proper acknowledgments. First of all, I'd like to thank the board from M3 that has done a spectacular job. Sheriff Mercurini and the entire Sheriff's Department for the use of their facilities at County Jail Number 5 and also 70 Oak Road. Mayor Ed Lee and the City of San Francisco for funding a program like M3. And also 5 Keys Charter Schools. And they've been very, very helpful in helping us execute this plan. But most importantly, Cisco Systems. Cisco and our graduates from their Cisco program, Johnny Clark and also Stanley Scott, they've done a spectacular job keeping the participants on track, and we want to thank them. So let's give everyone a round of applause.
I'm going to start right there. Thank you so much. We have a big, broad vision, and what you need today, when given the idea of a president, an African-American president who represents the fabric and the change of the United States of America, it embodied me with a certain amount of opportunity and vision to look into the most, I would say, the biggest opportunity for change in our lifetime. And that was inside the county jail number 5. Once again, it was not easy. It took the determination of the Sheriff's Department, every one of them. You can just go from the top to the bottom. The Sheriff opened up his doors. Captain Colson opened up his doors. Lieutenant Colmenero jumped in. Mel Jarrett came about. Clayton, I forgot Clayton's last name, forgive me, but he stepped up to the plate. And then you probably have never met Captain Sanford. I always call him Stanford, but I believe it's Sanford. He took it upon his Lieutenant Sanford. I want to give you Captain. He wanted to do something different to help provide the resources, the pathway to success that I needed. And I needed a lot of information in a very short amount of time. Without his technical help, without all of the other resources jumping into place, we would not be standing here today. Because this was something that had never been tried in the United States ever in a county jail facility. That was a big challenge. and to come to the table and not to ask for anything more than just to be able to have the opportunity to present the class. It was incredible. I wasn't even certified to teach the class at the time the division was made. We thank God that Cisco stepped up to the plate. Ironically, all we had was a blackboard and a chalk, piece of chalk and an eraser to teach the type of technical skills that you have to learn in the 21st century. Now, I don't know about anybody else, but I'm a dumbest dirt Texan. And I'm sitting here trying to teach individuals about technical skills and technical, the CMOS battery placement on a motherboard. Where is that? The CPU placement on a motherboard. And all we had was a blackboard, a piece of chalk, and an eraser. That is human determination at its highest form. Thank God that Steve Good is sitting in the audience this morning, because he saw the struggles that we were getting to, and now in our next class we have the use of the computer labs both at County Jail Number 5 and at 70 Oak Grove.
Great.
I'd like to give a Let's not look at Johnny Clark, or let's not look at M3 and their board, or let's not look at the Sheriff's Department and all of its resources that they have given us today. Let's look at the celebration of the individuals. Jason, for instance, he volunteered the entire time of the class to sit there and support me and be in the back of the class and offer, when I, you know, as I said, I'm a dumbest dirt Texan, I don't know everything. But he was there to help me, and you know, volunteer energy like that coming directly from within is huge. But I really want to focus on my guys and my ladies who really stepped up to the challenge. Ladies, you're the only two in my program right now, so I'm definitely expecting one of you two to step up at some point in this picture. And you know who I'm talking to if I'm looking you right in your eyes. Alright? It's no time to wee me on my leg and tell you it's raining. Now's the real show, and now they really want to know what you really can do. So gentlemen, please, come up and be recognized.
Floyd, Stan, John, Dr. Jones, everybody that was here. You know, it's been a long, hard road coming from jail. Everybody that believed in me, even when I didn't believe in myself, you know, these guys, you know, I was late for one class. I had like 5 people calling me, where you at, come pick me up, you know. I mean, the M3 movement has been great, you know, all your guys' support, you know, when I needed help with little road bumps, I had a lot of support to call and, you know, figure these things out, you know. So I gave it my all, and we passed, you know what I'm saying? I couldn't have done it without all my classmates either, you know.
My name is Oscar Salinas, and just like everything that Ben said, I wanted to thank Johnny for coming up with this idea. And like you said, you know, people said he was crazy, you know, and we're living proof that it's not crazy, you know. And I just, you know, wanted to thank, you know, my case manager, Ronaldo, who's in the back over here, for saying, you know what, you should go for it, you know. And I did, you know, and it was something that I thought, you know, it's been a long time coming, you know. I'm 42 years old. A year ago, you know, I was sitting in the county jail, and this year I was sitting in the county jail thinking, what am I going to do with my life? And I got to give it up to the Sheriff's Department, because they do have a lot of programs. If you really want the help, they do have a lot of programs. You know, today I'm 13 months and a couple of weeks sober, and Stanley, to Floyd, to my brother Joe over here, who I haven't seen in so many years, and I still remember as a kid going to creative music and always, you know, it's just a huge part of my life, and it's good to see you here in Hawaii too, so I appreciate that. And I still remember being in class and CMOS, what is that, you know? And a lot of us struggle, but I think we're kind of like a family now. I mean, we've kind of helped each other, and we broke down computers and everything.
Right.
And it's just living proof that it can be done. And I thank, you know, M3 too. I went to the breakfast this past weekend, and it was very encouraging. I mean, somebody came up to me and said, hey, look, send me your resume, and I know these two companies that can get you a job, and we'll fix it through resume. And it's because of M3 Breakfast, you know, and it's incredible, because I never would have thought that. It just gives me more hope. And, you know, a lot of us sometimes feel like, you know, because of our backgrounds and everything that's happened, we're kind of getting, you know, thrown to the side. And there's people in these rooms here that really believe that you can, you know, there is rehabilitation, and you can change. And I guess we're living proof of that. And I think that now going forward, that being the first class, you know, I look forward to working with Stanley and maybe coming back and teaching the class too. You never know, you know?
So, good afternoon, everyone. It's an absolute pleasure to be here with all of you today. I want to first congratulate my fellow classmates on a job well done. I don't know about the rest of y'all, but I'm headed to Disney World. I don't know about, I'd like to also sincerely thank our instructor, Stanley Scott, for his time and unwavering dedication to us. Your instruction and your patience and your devotion to us throughout the semester was invaluable. And from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much, man, for your time. I want to also give a shout out to Dr. Jones for providing us with the added bonus of mentorship hours. You know, initially I was like, oh man, this is another thing on my plate on top of it all. But I mean, the mentorship hours was invaluable because it covered more than just the actual class itself, but just life concerns, as one can imagine, coming from, you know, being incarcerated, there's definitely the ripple effect. It's not about just the act of incarceration, the actual fact that you're physically incarcerated. It's about the ripple effect that happens in one's life. And Dr. Jones's feedback and his input was also invaluable. So thank you, Dr. Jones. I want to personally thank Lou Gordon and Kevin Henley from the No Violence Alliance for your invaluable support and help in my reentry process. Words cannot express my gratitude towards both of you cats. I appreciate you guys were there for me from the very beginning, from the day that I came out of, that I stepped off the bus. You guys were right there, and I appreciate it. And I value your friendship as well as your service towards me. I also want to extend my gratitude to the SF Sheriff's Department and Ross Marcarimi for allowing the pilot test run of the Cisco Academy program to take place. It ain't fun being incarcerated, but if you are, SF County is not a bad place to be. I just created their next tagline, didn't I? It ain't fun being incarcerated, but if you're gonna be, San Francisco County ain't bad. Now, I don't expect any kind of reward or anything for that, you know, just the fact of you guys not showing up on my front doorstep, that would be thank you. Thank you.
Jones, and I was thinking of Abby's up in our yoga and meditation and all that stuff, and Floyd, thank you very much. And I was always like, I don't know if Peyton Smith from the San Diego Sheriff's Department, did. Met him at church and he mentioned about the program. I was like, to my girlfriend Jeannie, just pitching him, who's Cajun's mom. I said, I don't know if I'm qualified. I just said, go for it. So thank you, Jeannie. I appreciate all your support. And Cajun and I, we're the females on the crew, so.
I had already went to school in 98 for my certification, and then went back to school in 2011 to take up computer networking and alcohol and drug educator. And I was getting ready to take a vacation that I hadn't took in 11 years. And I got a phone call from Floyd to let me know that I'm going to a training to teach Cisco networking and an option to teach teaching. You know, so this class was a great opportunity for me to get a chance to apply some of the knowledge that I have been learning and watch people absorb the information that was given to me. It was huge. You know, and I want to thank everybody in that class. Chris, Louis, Victoria, Oscar, Benny, Thomas, Londell's not here. Mr. Bray isn't here. I want to thank them just as well, you know. And yeah, this has been a huge opportunity, and this is the beginning of many, many more, you know. So we all know about the computer field. There's always going to be another test to take, just to stay where you're at, stay current. So be prepared, you guys. You guys have always been prepared. You know, any challenges that you guys had, you let me know about it. You dumped it on me before class got started. And then we got a roll. So you guys used the facilities for exactly what it was. So I want to thank you guys very much for that. When I started teaching this class, I had three other jobs. Now I still go to school and I got two other jobs. But throughout the week, this is the most exciting part of my week, is to come in here with you guys.
I want you to listen very carefully to this individual because he's a volunteer. He's going to eventually be our inside instructor once we get him certified. And by the way, I can certify you. I wanted to come up here and get his experience because you have no idea that in breadth of what this man did for us inside of County Jail No. 5. He needs a standing ovation for what he did. He is amazing, amazing man, Mr. Jason.
Started with just teaching the veterans, and Mel Jarrett, my boss, told me about the Cisco class, and I had no idea what it was, and I had a lot of questions about it, and you know, I just came to the first class to check it out, see what's going on, and you know, I met Johnny, and I found out what his intentions were, and I said, "You're crazy. It's not going to happen. I don't believe in you." But I kept coming back to the classes and seeing what was going on, and I caught it. It is possible. I'm seeing it occurring as we speak. And the experience at County Jail No. 5, teaching the Cisco class, that was not easy. The students were so hungry. They wanted to learn so much more. They wanted more. They're like, "We don't know what you're talking about. Can you give us more?" And we only had so much to deliver, and we delivered as much as we could. I think the greatest experience is when you know you start out in jail and they don't know anything, and they have all this like desire to learn about computers, and then they get out of jail and you see them again outside, and you see them like still wanting to learn, they're still going, and they're still here, and that's an amazing feeling. Seeing that from jail, because you don't see that every day, not with everyone, and so these individuals are very unique individuals, and they're amazing, and I'm really, really proud of them. So.
But one of our individuals learned on the Blackboard, had nothing more than a book to keep him company from the time that we finished our program, just at the end of August until just a couple of days ago. He got out, I believe he got out on a Tuesday, if I'm not mistaken. He met with Floyd on a Wednesday. He had never been in our computer lab on 70 Oak Road. He had never been on NetCAD ever. He came in, sat down, took the test, and certified on that day. That's incredible. It takes some people 8 to 12 weeks to learn this. It takes, and more importantly, and Victoria will tell you, it's a very hard interface to learn how to get on NetCAD. You just don't walk in there like Google and do it. You have to do certain things. She learned my rap that day when she couldn't get on, but we all got through it. But these certificates mean more than that. It concludes a very real thing. We fail in San Francisco with 35-year-old males 80% of the time within 2 years. What does that mean? We're spending $106,000 of tax revenue when we know 80% of the time we're going to fail in the first 2 years with individuals who are released from county jail number 5 who return. So what we're doing with these certificates is giving individuals the power to go out and get that $53,000 job as opposed to relying upon the community to supply the $53,000. You know, we've had people fly in from Australia to meet with us and offer us opportunities. We've had people who didn't believe me 2 years ago when this thing started that came to the board meeting to offer opportunities. Right now, this paper represents your future. Take it, handle it carefully, but don't let it sit on the wall. Walk into Twitter, walk into Facebook, get your butt over to Google, get over to eBay, show them what you've done, talk about how hard it was for you to make it to where you were. You deserve that opportunity to be interviewed. You deserve that opportunity to be considered for the positions that are being made available. Do not let these papers go to waste. Please. There's no honor to this community. Reach out, stretch, make people go to churches. There are so many churches. Good evening. So at this time, we're going to read the letter that was presented to our top 4 students. Letter from Cisco Systems, and it reads thus. Congratulations on completing the IT Essentials course as part of the Cisco Networking Academy program. This hands-on lab-ran course has prepared you for exciting career opportunities in the technology industry. By completing this course, you have earned a certificate of completion for IT Essentials and acquired competencies that include the following. Define information technology and describe the components of a personal computer. Describe how to protect people, equipment, and environments from accidents, damage, and contamination. Perform a step-by-step assembly of a desktop computer. Explain the purpose of preventive maintenance and identify the elements of the troubleshooting process. Install and navigate an operating system. Configure computers to attach to an existing network. Describe the features, characteristics, and operating systems of mobile devices. Implement basic hardware and software security principles. Apply good communication skills and professional behavior while working with customers. Perform preventive maintenance and advanced troubleshooting. Assess customer needs, analyze possible configurations, and provide solutions or recommendations for hardware, operating systems, networking, and security.
Technological literacy is more important today than ever before, and Cisco is proud to provide you with the knowledge and skills necessary to build and maintain computers. Please accept my best wishes for your continued success. Sincerely, John T. Chambers, Chairman and Executive Officer. So congratulations. So, I want to present the first certificate to Lewis Honoré. Not here.